Hello everyone, what is going on? And the hype train is in full swing the past week. Oh man. So if you guys didn't know already, Age of Triumph was actually released with a patch this Tuesday for Destiny. And it brought back the old raids. The first raid that they brought back is Crota for this week. It's actually in a weekly featured playlist. And it's got different challenge modes and some different changes. And people are loving it so far. And I have yet to play Destiny since the patch. I've just been super busy and honestly super tired. I've been not feeling well lately. But I had to make this video because they released the Destiny 2 teaser. And I'm making this and uploading this on the same day. Tomorrow, we get a full Destiny 2 trailer. And so, obviously, everyone's excited. The teaser, as of the making of this video, is number 2 on the trending list on YouTube. And already has almost 1 million views. It might actually be over 1 million views by this point. I'm going to let you guys watch the trailer as a whole, and then I'm going to do a little bit of speculation afterward and let you guys know what I think is going on and, you know, point out a few specific things, and we'll go from there. So enjoy the trailer.
Okay, so I'm in this super boring meeting about something. I don't know, wasn't paying attention. Then, boom! It was like an ugly contest where everyone was a winner. This one dude's all raw, so I shot him. And then I shot this other one. Shot a couple extra guys just to be safe. I did a lot of shooting, if I'm being totally honest. Then, they destroyed my favorite store. Second favorite. There's that spicy ramen shop. I'm getting sidetracked. Look, long story short, I get busy. And I'm thinking, I've got this. You know, when you're in that, you go, I got this. But man, I so did not have it. Guess you have to be there. Well, better get back to it.
King, any day now.
Jeez, the guy has one drink coming.
So, I mean, let's all be honest with ourselves here. That trailer, or that teaser, was amazing. I mean, like, it just looked good. It confirmed a lot of things that we already knew were coming. And it's freaking Kate is always a win, you know what I'm saying? Like, he pretty much guided us through the Taken King campaign, right? And he's going to be probably back here in Destiny 2, we're thinking, and, you know, gonna be doing a lot of things for us. And we see the Vanguard actually fighting too in this. I'll try and post screenshots in amidst the gameplay here, but we see the Vanguard actually fight in this teaser a little bit. And obviously, this is the tower, this is Earth, this is, like, you know, this is the city that's being assaulted right now and completely destroyed by, very clearly, the Cabal. The Cabal are attacking. And we knew this was coming, right? Because original Destiny was Vex, right? Original Destiny, you know, was all about the Vex. Like, yeah, it introduces to the other races, but, you know, the Vex were kind of always, oh, these guys are crazy powerful, and these guys are the people that you're going to be fighting in the first raid. And then we had Dark Below, which is a Hive DLC. Then we had House of Wolves, which is obviously a Fallen DLC. And then we got Taken King, which was kind of, which was more of a Hive DLC, but also had, you know, it introduced the Taken, which weren't really anything super crazy new. They were just, you know, kind of revamped enemies. But so it was still technically a Hive DLC in essence. And, you know, they also had some Cabal in there, and we learned that, you know, the Cabal are going to be coming in the Taken King. And then Rise of Iron was also another Fallen base DLC, more or less, and introduced Siva Fallen, which is, you know, again, more of revamped enemies, not really any new new enemies. You know, it's just enemies being taken over by some kind of force, right? So we knew this Cabal expansion, or that the next thing was going to be Cabal. In fact, we expected that Rise of Iron would be a Cabal DLC, but it actually wasn't. So it was pretty obvious to us that, you know, oh yeah, that's, you know, obviously Destiny 2, they're going to have a Cabal-based expansion. Or, you know, it's not really an expansion, but it's going to start with the Cabal, right? And I'm honestly glad that they waited for the full sequel, because the Cabal are a big deal, right? Like, this invasion is huge. Like, they're going to invade the city. They're going to blow it up. It's going to be interesting. I was actually playing a D&D, a Destiny-based D&D that my friend had homebrewed earlier this week, and I was, and as soon as I saw this trailer, I was thinking, oh man, wouldn't it be cool to have a D&D based off of this before Destiny 2 came out? And you know, that would be pretty fun to play. But yeah, I mean, obviously, you know, Cabal is going to be a huge deal. They're going to be invading. Like, we knew what happened in The Taken King, right? There was a mission at the end of The Taken King where the crashed ship on the Dreadnought was sending out a signal to outside of the galaxy, you know, saying, hey, we failed our mission. It's sending it, obviously, to the Cabal Empire. So, obviously, the Cabal are going to be coming to our doorstep soon. We knew that. And honestly, I was excited for it. I personally think a Cabal raid would be awesome, because it'll be a little bit similar to the Vex raid. It'll be, you know, it won't be like a Hive raid. You know, the Hive raids are kind of random. They're very, very chaotic, and the Vex raids are all about precision and, you know, doing right things in the right order. And I feel like the Cabal raids will be somewhat similar, right? It's going to be very militaristic, excuse me, and you're going to have to maybe fight through waves of enemies, and you know, it could even be like a beachhead type thing where you're just literally just fighting through it. Obviously, there will be some puzzles, but I'm interested to see what they come up with in terms of a Cabal raid. I think it could be very, very interesting, very, very good. And I'm like, needless to say, I'm excited for this, right, guys? Like, come on. I mean, it's Destiny 2. Everyone lost faith in Destiny 1 a year ago. But when Bungie releases their teaser and their trailer for the full sequel, everyone got involved. Like, some of the biggest streamers that have never even played Destiny were just like, so can someone who knows what Destiny is tell me what the hell this teaser's what's happening in this teaser? And people were like, oh my god, you should play Destiny. And so, you know, like, I mean, Bungie just does a ridiculously good job hyping up their games. It's just they need to start living up to their hype, and I feel like I've said this before, but I feel like Destiny 2 is Bungie's chance at redemption for Destiny 1. Destiny 1 was really an experiment. The entire game was almost a beta of sorts. And I feel like, you know, if they iron out everything, you know, that they messed up in Destiny 1, this could be a real shot for them, in terms of, you know, making a game that everyone loves, and they really can do it. I mean, Destiny 2 is the best platform that they're gonna have. I do wonder if it's gonna be a little bit of a time crunch for them. You know, like, I mean, they have to push out the sequel this year. There's a lot of incentive from the publisher Activision financially to push out Destiny 2 this year. So, you know, I'm hoping it's not a rushed final product. I'm hoping we're not going to get a Destiny 1 style story. You know, I'm hoping we're actually going to get some nice quests like there were in Taken King and Rise of Iron. If we start out like that, that would be amazing. And we're also starting over, if you guys didn't know, for Destiny 2. They're not letting us keep any of our gear. I believe they're letting us keep our original characters if we want, like, you know, just our look, the look of our characters, not any of the armor or anything like that. But yeah, we're starting from scratch for Destiny 2. So that's interesting. I mean, this teaser, you know, obviously the Cabal are invading. So how is the character selection going to start is what I want to know. It's going to be really, really interesting to see how they're going to do that. But anyways, this video is getting a little long and I've just been kind of rambling. Let's actually talk about some specific screenshots in this trailer real fast. The first screenshot I want to run here is the initial explosion. And I don't know anything interesting about the screen, about this shot other than Zavala and his weapon. His weapon is actually a Service Regime. I didn't actually know that until now. Obviously, we see Cade with Ace of Spades, but we see both him and Zavala fighting side by side, and he is actually using Suros, to the best of my knowledge. Moving forward here, though, we see a giant Cabal boss bust through the door with double flaming swords. We see Ikora wielding Invective down there in the bottom corner, I believe. I'm pretty sure that's Invective. It looks like a shotgun to me. And yeah, this Cabal, obviously, guy has two swords, kind of a hammerhead look to him. Pretty interesting enemy that we've got here right off the bat. Those are pretty much the only shots from the teaser that are super interesting. I will be breaking down the trailer, the full trailer, once it drops tomorrow. Another thing that I want to debunk for you guys that you might have been hearing around is that there are two Traveler orbs. There were, in fact, two Traveler orbs initially in this teaser. At the end, during the Destiny 2 actual logo and picture with the city flaming in the background, you know, like the two was kind of up into the Traveler with the flaming city under it. There were actually two Traveler orbs. There was a smaller Traveler orb off to the left, I believe. I'm not 100% sure. I just heard this news just now, and I wanted to let you guys know, maybe if you heard it before I made this video, that it is not true. It was even in the Destiny 2 poster trailer, or like the actual poster, the picture, and it was all over the art that the official art that you know was for Destiny 2 on the Bungie Twitter account and the Destiny the Game Twitter account. So people were like, "Are there two Travelers here? What's going on?" But it was actually just an error, and they actually ended up fixing it in both the teaser and in the Destiny 2. Art. So there are no two Travelers, just one. Let's only deal with one for now, please. I don't know what two Travelers would mean. We don't even know what the one Traveler means yet, so hopefully we get a little bit more story, Bungie, in this next Destiny 2 game. But obviously I'm looking very forward to the trailer tomorrow. I hope you guys are as well. I mean, like, it's Destiny 2. Come on, let's be real. I mean, even though Destiny 1 was a disappointment, I'm still going to be absolutely keeping my eye on Destiny 2. And then this is one of the few games that I'm actually going to pre-order in the next year. Honestly, I've lost faith in pre-orders. You know, I bought For Honor, and unfortunately, I just don't play that game anymore, really. You know, and I've started to do that for a lot of games, and I realize, you know, I got to stop doing that. You know, it's just not a good practice to just delve into a game based on the hype, because, you know, it's just, you know, some of these games just aren't very good. Destiny 2 is the one game that I will be pre-ordering. If it's bad, then I made a mistake, and, you know, I don't know. I guess I won't buy Destiny 3, but unfortunately, you know, I mean, I love Bungie, I love Destiny, and I'm willing to give them one more shot. Other games I'm excited for this year include, actually, might hate me for saying this, Call of Duty. There's been a lot of news that they're going back to the World War II era. So if Sledgehammer can pull off something good, then I will end up buying this year's Call of Duty. I am actually excited to see what they're going to do with Call of Duty this year, because I do love the core game. I enjoy playing it from time to time. It's just the last couple of games. Black Ops 3 was good, but, you know, obviously Infinite Warfare, public matches are just not very fun. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I'll see you guys in my next one.